Do status symbols have economic value? Engaging in activities or displaying markers that are intended to signal one's wealth or income is often seen as potentially wasteful, but doing so can have economic benefits in certain settings. In developing countries, for example, credible financial information is often difficult to obtain, so visible signs of status can play an important role in economic transactions. This paper explores this dynamic by studying the economic value of obesity. Obesity is a common status symbol in poor countries, where, similar to Western countries in the past, rich people are more likely to be obese and fatness is associated with prosperity. These patterns differ markedly from those in higher income countries, and to estimate the economic implications, the author designed and implemented two experiments in Kampala, Uganda. The first tested whether obesity is perceived as a salient signal of wealth in this setting. To experimentally vary the appearance of body mass, a photomorphing software was used to manipulate several portraits of actual Kampala residents to create a visually thinner and fatter version of each original. These weight-manipulated portraits were then shown to a separate sample of Kampala residents, who were asked to rate a randomly selected set along several characteristics, including wealth. In some cases, the portraits were shown with no additional information, while in others, they were accompanied by common signs of status like place of residence or car ownership. Thinner portraits were perceived as normal weight, and fatter portraits were perceived as obese, so the comparison captures the effect of obesity relative to normal weight. This figure shows that when no other information is given, obese portraits are rated as being wealthier than their normal weight counterpart, and the effect is substantial. Obese individuals are perceived as being as wealthy as normal weight people who own a car, and the strength of the signal persists even when portraits are accompanied by additional information on place of residence or asset ownership. And while obesity is perceived as a signal of wealth, it has no impact on perceptions of beauty, health, life expectancy, self-control, ability, or trustworthiness. So, this first experiment shows that in this setting, body size is strongly correlated to beliefs about people's wealth. Does this translate into market benefits? The second experiment addresses this by exploring the credit market implications of obesity. 238 professional loan officers employed at 146 licensed Kampala financial institutions were recruited to review hypothetical borrower profiles and select those they would like to meet to discuss a loan application. These profiles were built by randomizing information collected from prospective borrowers living in Kampala, matched to weight-manipulated portraits randomly displayed in either their obese or non-obese version. The profiles also varied in whether they displayed a borrower's self-reported financial information. While loan officers knew these profiles were not real, they were told that at the end of the study, they would be referred to real prospective borrowers, and those referrals would be based on their experimental choices. And those choices reveal that loan officers do screen borrowers based on body mass, and that being obese leads to credit market benefits. When no additional financial information is included, a borrower attached to an obese portrait is rated by loan officers as more creditworthy, more financially able, and more likely to be approved. This translates into easier access to credit, as officers are more likely to request the referral of obese borrowers. Across all outcomes, the credit market benefits of weight gain are linearly increasing in body mass, and the obesity premium is large. In magnitude, it is comparable to the effect of a 60% increase in a borrower's self-reported income. And while the premium is strongest in the absence of financial information, obesity still matters even when borrowers provide self-reported information on income, collateral, and occupation. In this case, however, the premium drops by around 50 to 70%. This strongly suggests that the mechanism behind the obesity premium is asymmetric information. In the absence of verified financial information, obesity helps signal that a borrower is rich and thus more creditworthy, but the value of that signal diminishes when more information is made available. Are people aware of these benefits? To examine this, the author replicated her credit experiment with a sample of Kampala residents. These lay people were asked to guess how a loan officer would rate four hypothetical loan profiles, and the results show that while lay people are aware of obesity benefits in credit markets, they believe them to be substantially larger than they actually are. They also overestimate the wealth signaling value of obesity. While the average obese person in Kampala earns about $110 more per month than the average normal weight person, the average lay person estimates this difference to be over twice as large. This overestimation raises the possibility that loan officers may also be overweighting obesity when it comes to their lending decisions. An easy-to-access signal of wealth can facilitate credit flows when financial information is difficult to obtain, but the allocation of those flows may be inefficient if the signal itself is based on inaccurate beliefs. This is an important question for further research, as are the implications of these findings for health policy. In many countries, there may be a trade-off between the health risks of obesity and its benefits, which, at least in the credit context, appear to be large and salient. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on the economic value of status, barriers to lending in poor countries, and obesity.